Hello everyone and welcome. In this video, the functionality of the new Mesh Stack plugins will be demonstrated. Starting of a group of parts that are stacked, one on top of the other. The tool generates conformal hexapenta mesh with specific number of rows and mesh treatments around fillet areas. Moreover, 100% node-to-node connection between the solids is ensured. In order to access the tool, go to Plugins, Mesh Stack, Planar. In the first page of the interactive wizard, the selection mode pull-down menu controls the type of the input entities. The starting point can be either the 3D geometry or the middle surfaces of the parts. The bottom two options are used in the case where the user interrupts the wizard at the mesh inspection or stack characteristics page respectively. Automatic assignment of the selection mode is the default behavior. Press Next to continue. In the second page of the wizard, the tool's parameters exist. The user is needed to select the desired target and minimum element length. For more information on the functionality of each option, please refer to the description. Press Next to continue. The user can select to run the tool in batch mode and skip the next two pages. Let's run this normally by pressing Next. The middle surfaces of the geometry are extracted and projected onto a base 2D surface. The user is requested to inspect the automatically generated surface mesh of the base, and if desired, exit the wizard in order to edit. This is an important step, since this will be used as a map, in order to generate the solids. In case it is acceptable, press Next. A list view of the stack characteristics is prompted, and by selecting the items, a preview of the solids is generated. It should be noted that some of the columns are editable. For example, the number of rows of the generated solids can be modified. Additional columns are also available. Another example of an editable entry is the property name. Moreover, this tool supports edges recognition. In this example, the recognized edge types are a double edge on the bottom part and a single half edge on the top part. Specific mesh treatments with specific number of rows are applied on those parts. A very important option in this page is the stacking algorithm. The two available options are same as CAD position and stack parts on base. For example, in this case there was an intersection between the top two parts. By selecting the stack parts on base option, the top part will be depenetrated. As a result, an exclamation mark is printed in the status column, informing the user that the solids that will be generated will have a difference with the original geometry. By pressing Next, the solids according to the existing list view settings are created. In the last page of the wizard, there is a volume mesh report. In case there is a difference in the original geometry's volume and the volume of the generated solids, a warning will be printed. Press Finish to exit. In the next example, we are looking at a slightly different case. The parts are not planar, and additionally, there are multiple group of parts that are stacked on a base part. In such cases, the Mesh Flex Stack plugin is the appropriate tool. The functionality of the wizard is similar with the planar tool. By enabling the batch process checkbox, the user can select to create the solids without mesh inspection. The solids are generated with the default characteristics. The principle of the generated solids is the same. Hexapenta mesh with node-to-node connections between the parts. Thank you for watching.